Colorado Alliance for Family Equality is hosting its first CAFE Community Summit coming up in May. Here's Tom Biddle to take it from here.
The Colorado Alliance for Family Equality's first Community Summit is a day-long conversation of speakers, workshops, and network opportunities designed to restore, refocus, and revitalize Colorado's GLBT activist community in advancing the community's goal of achieving equality and fairness. With me tonight to talk about the summit and the history behind it are Karen Kellen, who is an attorney and mediator for the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, where she is co-chair of the LGBT employee group. Karen serves on Lakewood's Diversity Commission and co-chairs the Jefferson County Democrats LGBT Caucus. She has recently declared her candidacy for a seat on Lakewood's City Council. And John Ferguson, who is a consultant trainer living in Denver, where he works in the community to create change in racism and sexism. After a career in the international corporate world, John became a multiculturalism consultant in 2004. He serves on the board of PFLAG of Denver and is the chair of the CAFE Steering Committee. Welcome to Colorado Outspoken, both of you.
Thank you, Tom.
Thanks for being here. John, the first question I have really is for you, since I'm kind of ignorant about CAFE. Mm-hmm. Could you tell us a little bit about the Colorado Alliance for Family Equality and how the organization came about and what its purpose is?
Well, the Colorado Alliance started, first of all, it is an alliance. So it's not a group of individuals. It's an organization of organizations. Now we have about 40 members. And it was started as a coalition or alliance to support equality in marriage for our community. About 3 years ago, when the Ref I campaign came along, well, before that, when the campaign came out of Colorado Springs against us, we sort of folded into that and supported that campaign. And since then, since it lost, we realize now that that's not an issue that we can continue to sort of focus on. And so we're really trying to bring our community together on the broad front of all the issues that we face every day in our lives.
Absolutely. And it seems that since the election, you know, people have been maybe feeling bad or feeling a little bit lost and dislocated and in the need for some revitalization. Yeah. And Karen, I was looking at the materials for the summit, and I noticed that your keynote speaker says that his message is, quote, a word of hope for the lost, healing for the sick, comfort for the lowly, and restoration for the wounded. It was a bit dramatic, I thought, but I wondered how these adjectives describe many average Colorado LGBT citizens who in figurative ways might be feeling that dislocated since the election.
Well, they definitely described me right after the election. And while there are a lot of good results at the election, being a Democrat and all, it was definitely disappointing because I thought Colorado was ready. And then we have the election and the huge letdown in terms of getting our rights finally. And I kind of looked around and said, where do we go from here? And I saw a lot of other people really feeling depressed and defeated. And that's the last thing we need as a community.
Absolutely. I think that people have put a lot of stock into the domestic partnership and marriage questions, and as if those were the only issues that were out there. And it seems that marriage equality is the biggest issue. And I wonder if that, John, if you think maybe that emphasis has taken away attention from other issues that are just important to us. What else should we be paying attention to?
There's lots of other things we should be paying attention to. That was an important issue for us to focus on because it was brought to us by the religious right. And we had to challenge that. We had to stand up to it. We tried to. If we had won that, that would have been like the coup of the ages, I guess. But we didn't. It would have given us real equal standing in law and in society. There are lots of issues in terms of schools, in terms of our churches, and in terms of other areas of our lives, in terms of the workplace, for example. So there are lots of different issues that different organizations in our community are working on, and we wanted to bring all those people together and talk about all those different issues. So we're going to have a series of workshops at the summit, and various organizations will be talking about the things they're doing in schools, in workplace, against hate crime, and so forth. And then we'll try as part of the summit, come together and bring people together to do work on those various issues.
Right. I want to talk specifically about the content of some of those workshops and things a little bit later. But this all kind of falls under the umbrella of what your planning committee co-chair, Mr. Thompson, says, calls a more mature, more sober, more resolute new wave of activism in Colorado than what we've seen before. And I wondered how activism has changed. What will this mature, sober, resolute activism look like?
Well, that's exactly what we're hoping to find out at the summit. The idea is that we take a look at some of these issues and then we come together to really look to the future, to where we're going, to what we want to do, and what we want to accomplish, and how we're going to get there. And I do think we need to reevaluate how we're going to get there and what we've done and how we've done it in the past. Because while we've had some successes, on the whole, we're still not getting those basic rights. So our more mature way is yet to be defined.
Okay, that's one of the reasons for the summit coming together. John?
One of the things I know it involves is this, that we aren't going to win because we are go to the legislature or do some kind of a TV ad campaign. We're going to win because we as individuals and as groups reach out to people in our community and make contact with them and help them understand who we are, which is to say, just like everybody else.
Of course.
Just as different as everybody else and just the same as everybody else. So that we're not bugaboos that they have to be afraid of. They're their next door neighbor. And so we want to find ways to reach out at that personal level to people.
Absolutely. And now we can get back to some of those specific kinds of workshops that the summit will feature, and either of you can respond to this, whoever might be more knowledgeable about that. The people who come and participate, what kinds of activities will they find? What will greet them? What kinds of things will they be doing at the summit?
Well, one of the workshops is going to be one that's done by the Boulder Valley Safe Schools Coalition. They have an absolutely model program for how to go into schools and create curriculum change and create change in the hearts and minds of school staff, teachers, principals, and everybody else who's in schools, in order to gain acceptance for students who are now coming out in middle school, trans students coming out in middle school. One of the other people that will be part of that workshop are people coming out of Larimer County from the Loveland and Fort Collins schools who are just about to start a safe schools program. So it'll be an opportunity for people to see a model program of how it was done in Boulder and then see another example of somebody who's just starting out and what they're doing to work on safe schools in their community. So people who come to the summit will have a chance to say, how could I do that in my community?
Oh, that sounds so wonderfully positive. Karen, what else? What will you be doing at the summit specifically? Have you got an assignment? Have you got a role that day?
Well, I'll probably be running around a lot and doing some organizing here and there. But we have basically five different tracks that we're working on for the summit. We have the diversity track, which highlights the diversity in our community, people of color and transgender issues. We have the health and safety track, which goes along with what John was talking about. We have the legislative and legal track, which is probably one of my strong points, talking about where we are in the legislature, where we are moving forward on the legal front. We have the communities of faith track, and we also have the movement, past, present, and future.
That sounds wonderful. And you have organizations, as you were saying, John, that represent all of those different tracks, education, the faith, everything like that, who are planning to attend. Are there any specific participants that you're particularly excited about?
Yeah, we're having, I know the center will be coming, and they will be doing some health seminars. We're still working out the details of exactly what their focus is going to be. But that plays into the health and safety track. We'll also have Equal Rights Colorado talking on the legislative fronts, where we are with the legislation that's been coming through this legislature, and where we're going in the future with that.
So a good way to come off of what was a disappointing election season, and we had our hopes on up on two things that were on the ballot. We had Ref I and we had 43, and a way to rebound positively and bring a positive energy to the aftermath of that.
Absolutely, and that's a huge focus, especially for political junkies like myself.
The ERC has really figured out, not just by themselves, but in working with other organizations around the country, new ways to work on legal and legislative issues to try and develop better alliances with the people in the straight community, so that it's not seen as this is just for gay people. It's for equal rights for everybody.
Exactly. I think that when gay people, quote, win, these kinds of everybody actually wins
right.
in society.
Right.
If any of our viewers would like to get involved or attend the summit, Karen, do you have any information for them on how they can do that?
Absolutely. They can send an email to cafesummit, that's one word, at AOL.com. And if they happen not to have email, is there anyone like that anymore?
I don't know.
I don't know. But
my mother.
Yes. my mother, too. They can call 303-482-1690.
We wish you the very best with the summit. I wish you the greatest success with it, and we hope that it's a big victory for you.
We hope so,
yeah.
too.
Well, it definitely sounds like the summit is the place to be for everyone interested in advancing GLBT causes, both outside and inside the community. Remember, the summit will be held Saturday, May 19th, and you can get all the details from our website at ColoradoOutspoken.org. I want to thank my guests, Karen Kellen and John Ferguson, for being with us. I'm Tom Biddle for Colorado Outspoken.